It's very important to recognize heart disease because it's the leading cause of death in both men and women.
The goal of Rush's Structural Heart Disease Center is to treat patients who have valvular heart disease as well as structural heart disease.
Over the years, we have garnered a huge experience in this area, and I think one of the successes is that we've been able to assemble a team of experts, a team of experts in imaging, cardiac surgeons, interventional cardiologists, anesthesiologists who work together, who have a vast experience in making sure this is a safe and efficacious procedure. Americans are living longer. And because of that, we are seeing things that we never used to see. And one of them is an age-related degeneration of the aortic valve called aortic stenosis.
Aortic stenosis is one of the common causes of heart disease, especially in the elderly.
The deposits of calcium, like hardening of the arteries, this is hardening of the valve, builds up over many years.
Eventually, the narrowing becomes so severe that the heart is unable to pump enough blood to the rest of the body, leading to many symptoms such as extreme fatigue, shortness of breath, and maybe even fainting. Untreated can also lead to death. We now have a less invasive and safer method to replace the stenotic aortic valve. The way TAVR is done is that a wire is inserted in the femoral artery and it is threaded all the way up to the heart. Once that wire is in place, we can advance a balloon over it, which dilates the narrowed valve. And also, then we can deliver another balloon, which is carrying the new valve, and deploy the new valve in its place.
So in contrast to a surgical procedure where they actually excise the old valve, we implant the new valve right over the old valve. In fact, the old valve acts as an anchor for the new valve implant.
So going back to our patient here, the left coronary heights are a concern.
We meet weekly at a conference and we review each of our patients individually.
I felt a pressure in my chest that kind of wouldn't go away. I was feeling for quite some time shortness of breath. I said, you know, we're going to go to check this out.
Kathleen presented to our multidisciplinary heart valve clinic where we have a full spectrum of physicians and other healthcare providers. We felt the team, the multidisciplinary team, felt that a less invasive TAVR type procedure would allow her to ambulate and recover more easily on a faster basis than with surgery.
You've had all your preliminary testing completed. I think there's nothing else to do except to schedule the date for your procedure.
Let's do it.
During a TAVR procedure, it requires a team of doctors. We're working next to each other in the room. We will have cardiac anesthesiologists. We will have imaging people. We will have the physicians that are doing the procedure.
Boy.
Kathleen's prognosis is excellent. She should have resumption of normal activities within 3 to 4 days after her procedure.
Kathleen, my name is Julie. I'm one of the nurse practitioners.
I feel great. I feel relieved and I feel grateful that I was able to do this procedure. It is a miracle. We all said that in the hospital. It's just remarkable. The recovery, outstanding. Go for it if you get a chance.
Rush has been there from the very beginning. Some of the finest specialists in the country, cardiac surgeons, imaging people, even pediatric surgeons, pediatric interventionalists, who all work together as part of a team to ensure the most innovative, effective, and safe care of patients with these kinds of problems.